welcome to the Splatoon multiplayer, which is the main chunk, I guess, of Splatoon. I have been playing a good bit of it. We are level 12. Of course, we are not as high up as those Japs and their level 20s and their arrow spray, RMGs or whatever. God. It's been an interesting day. I've definitely been a little addicted to the game, trying to figure out what is effective combos and whatnot. We're going to go ahead and drop a bomb. Unfortunately, you can't see where the hell I aimed it since it's on the Wii GamePad, but that's okay, whatever. All right, so we're going to go ahead and try and cover up the map. If you don't know what the goal of the game is, well, I guess it depends on the game mode. In this particular game mode, it is called Turf Wars, and in this one, we have to cover up the map with as much of our ink as possible. Whoever has the most ink on the map wins. So you can focus down on killing people, and it can be pretty effective, considering then they won't be able to spray down any ink, but you're also going to want to make sure that you're covering up the map as much as possible. I've been dabbling around trying to figure out what works well, and I think I finally found something that's pretty good. So if I ever want, so I'm using this, what is it called? Dot 52? I'm not sure. I'm using this particular weapon. Where the hell this guy go? Oh, there he is. And it actually has a really effective weapon set. It's like, if I want to kill that person over there, I can throw a seeker. And if they don't move out of the way, they're going to die. Of course, it is pretty easy to move out of the way. Let me go ahead and bomb a different part of the map because we're losing a little bit of map control. Now, this is a pretty solid area to have. I mean, look how much ink we get to control by holding this section. So I'm just kind of like camping here, making sure no one crosses by. But yeah, no, I really like this weapon. Even though it doesn't have a lot of range, I can get behind someone and spray the shit out of them, and it kills them pretty quick. So that's pretty nice. And if they're pretty far away, again, along a straightaway, boom, I shoot them with the seeker missile. And it makes me incredibly happy. Now, it should be noted that I've learned, apparently, oh boy. apparently, you don't have to cover the walls in this game because they do not count as a turf. So that can be pretty important to learn because sometimes in the first few rounds I played, I definitely spent a lot of time sitting there going, okay, I gotta cover the walls. They're not covering the walls. I'm totally gonna get them. And no, I was just being a doublet. But I've learned. I'm becoming fresh. I am learning the ways of the Splatoon Warriors. And one of those ways is last second bombing an area of the map, and which you will be able to see soon enough. Like that. Well, that was a good first match for us to record. The match before this was bad. Like, holy shit. I think that was the hardest I've ever had my shit kicked in this game. Because it was against an entire team of people with that weapon that my top teammate has. That golden MG seems to be, like, the best weapon in the game. And I think you unlock that by beating the campaign, which I haven't done yet. And it's kind of screwing me. Because apparently you can get a lot of gear from playing the campaign. And so I've been playing all the way up to level 12 without beating the campaign and having the very low level stuff. It's not that effective. But yeah, no, I went against a team, and three of their guys had the arrow spray MG, the gold one. And it's a really fast shooting weapon. It's kind of like the weapon I have now. It doesn't really have a lot of range, but it shoots so goddamn fast that it just immediately murders you on sight. And so with three of them having it, oh my god, we were literally locked in our spawn. It was so bad. But that's why I left. Now, thankfully, these rounds aren't really all that long. It's actually kind of nice. It's a change of pace. We're so used to playing, okay, I guess I'm just dead. But, that guy's got the fucking gun. But it's so nice, I guess, just to play a multiplayer game that is really short. You know, it's like, oh, 3 minutes, boop, done. Even though I do like longer form games, it just works out in this one, because let's be honest, I don't want to sit here for 10 minutes trying to cover up the map. I feel like once the point is established, it's established. So let me just bomb this area because these fuckers are coming after me. Yep. Oh man, look at this guy. Hey, I have a seeker. He wasn't locked on anybody, so I didn't really do much. Okay, I gotta get out of here. Because they are coming for my butt! Oh, I'm on bait. Okay, alright, that's bad. That's fine. I gotta climb up this wall. And then kill the shit out of them. There you go. It's so worrying when, people disappear into the ink and you're like, oh god, where the hell did they go? You just kind of have to hope for the best and be like, alright, well, according to their momentum, they went over here. I'm gonna scare that guy with a seeker. Yep. Seekers can't go over walls, so they're never really anything to worry about if you're standing on a platform that is pretty high up. I'm gonna die. Oh, yeah. That was some latency shit. But, yeah. It's nice at the very least you can fake him out. You can be like, hey, no, there's a seeker coming after you. Run away. How's my team doing? It looks like we're not doing all too well. But thankfully they have a charger dude, and that's kind of screwing them over because the chargers, unless you're like fucking knocking it out of the park with your KD, you're pretty useless to your team. I mean, I guess that's a pretty standard thing. If you're not getting a lot of kills and you're not doing really well and holding off the map, yeah, not doing so extra team. But it's more noticeable when you're a charger. Because at the very least, if you're sucking with a paintbrush or a splat roller, then at least you're covering up the map. So we're gonna go ahead and shoot this off somewhere. So that way they can sit there going, shit, we gotta cover up more of our side of the map. No! Will I get him? Oh yeah! And that is why I love this seeker. Hello. I think we won this. There is a guy on our side of the map, but it's too late. The best thing you can do in this game is just go over to the other side of the map and fuck up their spawn. They're sitting there going, no, now we have to replenish everything, and you just keep on over to the map, and it's so nice, until they do it to you. Then everything sucks. Ah, gosh, ever since I started using this weapon, I've been getting so many more points. Like, I would always be at the bottom of the team in this fucking game when I was using all the other weapons, but this one is giving me a little bit more of a chance, which is nice. Maybe I'm just getting better because I've been playing the game throughout the weekend, but I'm gonna say it's the weapon. I think the weapons define how well you're gonna do. I mean, if I was rolling around with a roller, I'm not gonna get as many kills as someone who's, say, using a ranged weapon. Unless the other team sucks. Unless the other team is god-awful. Now, I'm sure there's, like, some kind of meta strategy I could try doing. Like, oh, rush over to their side of the map, and then seeker spam the hell out of them. And I can do that. And we killed each other. Okay. You know, I'm always happy to trade with an arrow spray RG dude. Because that's like, oh man, that guy had the better weapon than me. Doesn't matter. Of course, I didn't kill him with my weapon, I killed him with my seeker, so it doesn't really matter in that regard, I guess. Oh, and you just saw the thing that pops up when someone is trying to jump down on you. Now, you can jump... Ooh. You can jump to your teammates. Oh, there's a guy behind me. Oh, he got killed by my seeker! Oh, I'm so fucking dead. Oh my god. I gotta get out of here. Okay. Anyways, you can jump over to your teammates, which will save you a lot of time if you're spawning in. But, I don't do that a lot, because that's time spent where I could have just been doing this. Oh boy! Alright, let me just bomb the area. Oh look, they have two people here. I'm gonna hate this guy. This airy gris guy? I don't like him. He's got the fucking eye. Look at this asshole. Get the fuck out of here. Alright, we gotta kill these guys. Like we said in the last round, the worst thing you can do, or the best thing you can do, is go over to the other opponent's side and fuck them. Just go over there and ruin their day, ruin their map control. And currently, we're not doing too bad. They did have that little incursion there, which kind of sucked, but we still have a good portion of the middle under our control, which we can't see too well because we're not in a high spot. I would do that right now. Another thing that's also awesome is when you have the high ground and you can just sit here going, I'm covering up the map far more effectively than you. Oh boy. You got a guy trying to snipe me. Oh boy. Yep. Ah no! Fuck! He has a mine. I haven't encountered those a lot. Because I guess they're just kind of like end level stuff. But I guess those are pretty effective too. Shit. So, I guess the MG is really fucking fantastic. You can put down mines, you can shoot out guns really quick. Oh, Lord. Alright, we're gonna cover mid and just throw that. Go, my splat roller friend! Cover up their side of the map. How are we doing? Oh, we fucking won this. Oh, my God. We have at least like 70% of the map covered. Let's see if I can get my super. All right. Ow. Last second charger. Whew. You know, I actually want to like try and use the charger weapons because they kind of, they remind me of other multiplayer games or multiplayer shooters, you know? Here's this weapon that you have to have some decent accuracy with, and if you have accuracy, boom! A person's instant killed. It is literally a one-shot weapon if you charge it up and shoot it. The only problem is that the game's controls are a little bit, eh. It feels like the gamepad's analog stick is fighting against me whenever I'm playing the game. And I've messed with my sensitivity, I've tried the gyro controls. The gyro controls actually are pretty, I wouldn't say good, but they kind of make up for some of the flaws that the analog sticks are having with this particular game. And I don't know, I played a lot of games with analog sticks and I've never really found it to be a problem to like quickly aim at someone when I'm using a semi-automatic weapon. So I think that's just something they did with the game. Somewhere along the line, they did not have the analog controls be in line with every other kind of game that we know of. And so it ends up being better to use the gyroscope, because then you can just kind of fling your arms around and aim faster than you normally would be able to. Just like you would be able to with a mouse and keyboard. Oh boy, there's a guy behind me. Oh shit, okay. Oop! I tried to bomb him, but I'm not really good with the targeting with the bomb. You have to like aim with your gamepad, but I'm always doing it in like a rush, and it's like, I don't know. All right, now that guy, 90% chance he's got the Kraken's flat brush build. Yep, there you go, this son of a bitch. Fuck you, buddy. So, the Kraken is also a pretty powerful special. You just basically go, nah, I don't want to die, but I do want you to die, and you just charge at people. Of course, all they have to do is submerge and get themselves away, but if they're in enemy territory, there's not going to be a lot of ground there for them. Oh boy. Howdy, sir! Oh, he's so fucked. Okay. Where are people on the map at this time? We're gonna say they're there. Oh, no! Okay. It's so scary when someone's attacking you and you're fucking in the middle of throwing down the bomb. You're like, oh, no! This is bad for me. How are you not fucking dead? Oh, my God. I hate dealing with splat rollers. Because it's just kind of like this super paranoid area of like, oh boy, I hope they don't fucking one-shot me. Because they can, if they're paying attention. So they've actually got some decent map control going on. Uh-huh. So we're gonna go over here and just kind of ruin that for them, because goddamn do we need this side of the map. Okay, thank you, high ground. Now you can go through these grates, which I'm not gonna do. I mean, that's gonna kill me. Is that guy alive? Oh, fucking, okay. One second as I kill everybody. Just kidding. All right, we're going to bomb that back part of the map that we spent so much time on. I love that you can do that the last second. And then it actually affects the map. Okay, this might be close. Yeah, they got it. Okay. You see that entire, like, right segment that they fucked us with? I can guarantee that was their splat brush. God, we didn't have a splat roller dude at all. I feel like if you don't have at least one splat roller guy, and they do, you're at a higher chance to lose. It's not a guaranteed lose. I've won plenty of times against a team that's had, like, one or two splat rollers, and my team doesn't. But it's just so easy to just cover the map. All you have to do is hold right trigger and go forward. And suddenly, it's just an entire line. It's so fucking wide. It's actually even really effective at range, too. If you get on top of a structure, like, say, the middle of that map right there, and just start, like, spamming the right trigger, it covers so much of the area. But I like using ranged weapons, and I use the splat roller pretty much exclusively for a pretty long time, so it's not like I'm going to go back to it while I'm trying to level up everything else. Also, like I said, with this gun, I feel like I've been a little bit more effective. Ah, for fuck's sake. Sometimes I feel like there's a little bit of latency. Obviously, oh no, we're going against Japanese people. They're really fucking far away. I hate it. I hate it so much. Sometimes you just die to something long after you should have, or before you should have. Like, say a guy, you know, you just die, and all of a sudden you see that this black guy, or the guy who killed you, swings his brush towards your general direction. Like, oh, so you're telling me in the future is when he killed you. Although, I guess to be fair, on his screen, he did get you. And that's what you just kind of have to accept. Now we're going to bomb the middle of the map.
There's so much blue ink over there.
I really like how every round the ink changes. Now, you can lock it so you're always the same colors, but that's no fun. I'll just be like, oh god, we're blue! Oh god, we're green! Let's try to cover everything up! Just cover this side. Oh. What is my teammate doing? What the fuck was that? I don't understand teammates sometimes. It's like you give them the perfect opportunity, you knock down a lot of health, and they have the jump on an enemy, and they can steal some health. Fuck it up. It's just so disappointing. How are we doing on the map? We're doing... eh. Nothing amazing. I'm gonna block that, scare the dude maybe. I gotta go over there, save my teammate. Nope, he's dead already. Okay. Ugh, for fuck's sake. At least it's not the MG, right? It's just this guy with his double damage buff. Oh, I can use my jump pad too. Okay, that was close. If he had been given a few more seconds, I might have just been instant killed, and that would have sucked. That guy's fucked. Cover the middle of the map! Is there someone on our side? No! Good! We're gonna do some area... denial of area shit. Although I probably should have just used that on their base. This is not like that thing last block. Alright, let's show my teammates. Yeah, okay. Killing people does make them explode into ink, so it can be pretty effective. I've seen some games just turn like, oh boy, four people just died in the middle, and that was it. Yes. I don't know what it is about this gun that makes me get so many points. Like, with the splat roller, I've gotten up to like, you know, 12 kills in a game. But I don't know what really counts towards points. Is it covering the map? Am I doing a better job with a ranged weapon than I am with the actual, like, weapon design for covering the map? I don't know. Oh god, there are a lot of level 20s in here. That's scary. I hope those level 20s are on my side. If we see Vegas on the other side, I'm just gonna have to say, good luck to my team. If we see those two Japanese guys, on the other side, along with Vegas. I'm just going to say it's GG.